have been tracking Milton all morning, and this made landfall late last night at around 8:30 near Siesta Key in Sarasota as a powerful Category 3 hurricane, and it tracked over Florida through the overnight hours, and it stayed at hurricane strength. Right now, still at hurricane strength to the latest advisory, just a little bit weaker, Category 1 strength of winds right around 85 miles per hour. It's continuing to push off that east coast of Florida, so they're starting to see improving conditions, and Milton should be fully out of Florida later this morning, and then we'll continue to track in the Atlantic in that eastward direction, where it'll diminish out there. As for the rest of us, looks like we're pretty quiet here across central Mississippi. They had some pretty significant totals over the past 24 hours across parts of Florida, and you can see over towards parts of Tampa, south of Spring Hill, over towards Kissimmee, right around 12 to over 14 inches of rainfall. A lot of flooding concerns over there and high surge, and over towards Daytona Beach, Deltona, Orlando, right around 5 to 8 inches, and over towards Gainesville, Palm Bay, Yeehaw Junction, right around 2 to 5 inches. So they've had a lot of rainfall over the past 24 hours. A lot of knocked down trees, over 3 million people waking up to no power across parts of Florida this morning. Right here across central Mississippi, we are waking up to some gorgeous weather conditions, clear skies, and high pressure is just off to the northwest. This continues to control our weather over the next couple of days, and the sunshine will continue for us over here. Temperatures across the region, we are starting off the morning into the 50s for many of us, 59 here in Jackson, 51 over in Tupelo, low 50s up in Nashville, feeling good over there, 54 over in Little Rock, and down towards the coast, 66 over in Biloxi, and we have 73 over in New Orleans. Good morning over there. As we head throughout the day today, I do expect another day of cloudless conditions through the rest of the day. Temperatures looking to be in the 80s right around noon, topping off in the mid 80s for many of us across the area. 86 here in Jackson, warm sunshine, and then going into the 70s right around 6 p.m. Overall, a comfortable day with warm temperatures for this afternoon across the area. Many of us in the 80s, low 80s along our eastern counties, 86 over in Jackson and 85 over in Bellizona. Looking at a lot of sunshine. So if you're heading out to the Canton Flea Market or you're heading out to the fair later today, we have great weather conditions. The weather will hold up pretty nicely for today and through the rest of this week and even going into the weekend. High pressure will continue to be in control just off to our west. Temperatures looking to be in the 80s for the afternoon and starting off the mornings in the 50s. But I am already watching our next cold front looking to arrive next week. So this will swing through and reinforce some cooler air. We could be looking at mornings in the 40s and warming up to the 70s for the afternoon temperatures. So another nice fall air is on the way. Temperatures over the next couple of days will stay slightly above average in the mid to upper 80s. Warmer stay looking to be Sunday this week, getting pretty close to 90 degrees. And then you can see those temperatures start to decrease as that cold front moves through. Afternoon temperatures looking to be in the 70s. It's going to feel very nice out there. But over the next couple of days, not bad of a 7-day forecast. Lots of sunshine through the next several days. And then that cold front moves in. You can see those temperatures dropping down into the upper 40s, low 50s going into next week to start off the morning.